Good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. I hope that by now you have learned about the advanced parts of Writer 3 module. I also know that you have reached this stage after having successfully passed the written exam for the Writer 3 module. This module is about the advanced portion of Impress. You will be learning about the various advanced options of Impress in this module. You will now be learning about all the options that had not been taught to you earlier in the basic module of Impress. All of you must learn this part carefully. Come, let us first revise a little about the basic part of Impress that has been taught to you earlier. Can you tell how you will type in a blank slide? You can use the text tool to type in a blank slide or on any slide. How can you insert a new slide and in how many ways can you insert a new slide? A new slide can be inserted in two ways. In the first method, using the mouse or touchpad, right click on the slide pane and from the options that come up, select the new slide option. A new slide will be brought up. The other method is that you click on the insert menu and select the new slide option. To apply different kinds of animations on the slides, which options would you need to use? To apply different kinds of animation on the slide or on an image, you will need to use custom animation. How can you get multiple copies of an image which appears in different colors? You can use the option duplicates to get more than one copy of an image. This option also allows you to set the starting color and the ending color for the copies. Now, all of you switch on your computers and using any of the methods taught to you, open the Impress file. Let us now begin today's class. You all had learned about some of the options of the menu bar, formatting bar, and the drawing toolbar. Now you will be learning about the remaining options. And in today's class, you will learn about the options of the standard toolbar. You will get to know what is the standard toolbar. You will also learn how you can get to use its various options like new, open, save, display grid, slide, slide layout, and slide design, etc. Then you will learn about the line and filling toolbars, like the options for line, width, color, and you will also get to know how you can hide or show these options. Now, you first go ahead and insert 5 blank slides in your Impress file. Type something in the first slide. You can type about yourself. Next, in slide 2 and 3, draw some shapes using the drawing toolbar and then design the same. In the fourth slide, use the gallery option to insert a picture and also apply the master page on the slide. On the fifth slide, type out your name using the font work gallery and design the same. Have you all been able to apply the design or format that you had been asked to apply on all the 5 slides? If you haven't done so, then quickly apply the said design or format. Let us watch this video now and see how we can insert new slides in our Impress file. So to insert the new slides, take your cursor or the pointer to the slide pane, right click on it and click on the new slide option. And you will see that a new slide has been added to your Impress file. We do this 5 times to be able to add 5 new slides as is required. Click on the slide pane, right click and then choose the new slide option. Now you can see the first slide is a title slide. Now if you want to add a title, you can click where it says click to add a title and you can change the layout also if you desire. Right now we want this to be a title slide, so we keep this as title slide. Click here to add a title and we can add any title that we want. In this case we are typing Computer Shiksha. So we have added a title called Computer Shiksha. Next, bring the cursor to the place where the text can be typed and click there. You will see the cursor blinking and you can start typing your text. So this is how you can type in a new slide in your Impress file. So we are typing about Computer Shiksha, like Computer Shiksha is an 80G and 12A. You're simply using the keyboard to type, as you have seen here. So far you have learned how you can insert new slides in your Impress file. And then we are now using the title slide. We have added a title and then we have come to the text area and we are adding the text, or we are typing the text. Computer Shiksha is an 80G and 12A certified non-profit NGO registered in Gurgaon. You can type whatever text you want to. In case a text has been shown to you and you are asked to type that text, you can type in that text on a new slide. We can add further. Computer Shiksha is an 80G and 12A certified non-profit NGO registered in Gurgaon, working towards computer literacy. We can add some more words. Among underprivileged. Among the underprivileged. So this way you have learned to add new slides, then take a title slide, add a title and also add text in the slide. Now if we want to work on the second slide, we go to the slide pane and click on the second slide. You will notice that this is also a title slide, but to change it to a blank slide, we go to the properties in the slide layout and click on blank slide option. Now we have a blank slide. In this slide, let's use the drawing toolbar. Select one of the tools here. We have selected the cylinder and then we bring the cursor into our second slide and drag a cylinder as is being shown here. So you can make a cylinder. When you select the cylinder, you will see these dots appearing on your image. Now you can also work with this drawing or the image using this toolbar. You can change the outline type. You can change the width of the outline. And if you want, you can change the color of the outline also, as is being shown in the video. So if you scroll down, you will see many more colors available. Select a color of your choice by scrolling up and down and selecting the color that you want, so that that color gets applied on the outline in your image. You can also choose to color or use a gradient or a bitmap inside the image. So we've chosen bitmap, and then if you click on the drop down button, you see many options for the bitmap. If you click on the type that you want, you will see that your image gets colored or gets filled with that kind of color. Let's go to the next slide and work on that. So we select this slide by going to the slide pane and clicking there. Again, go to the slide layout, select blank slide option so that this slide also becomes blank. Let us now use an image from the drawing toolbar. We have chosen the diamond image. Once again, let's drag and we get a diamond image on the slide that we are working on. Again, if you select this, you see number of points coming. You can change the outline to the type that you want. Again, you can increase or decrease the width of this outline by using this option here in this toolbar. You can change the color of the outline that you have made. And again, if you click on the drop down button for color, this time let's choose gradient. And if you click on the next drop down button, you have different types of gradients. Once you click on the one which you want, select that, and you will see that gradient gets applied to the diamond or to the image that you have made on this slide. We want to work on the next slide. So we scroll down in the slide pane, go to the fourth slide, click on it, and we have the fourth slide to work on. Again, this is a title slide. Let's change it from the slide layout to blank slide. This time, let's work with the gallery option. So if you see in the drawing toolbar below your slides, there is a gallery option. Click on that and your gallery option opens as is being shown in the video. Now here you can select any of the themes that are available in the gallery. So you have transport, you have symbols. You can select any of them which you like. For instance, we are scrolling up and down and we select one of these. Let's select this particular symbol. Right click on it, click on the copy option of the insert, and you can insert this image in your slide. Now you can see the dots appearing on this, the green dots, and you can use them to resize this image. So you can take it up or down and make the size bigger or smaller as required. Now let's change this with the master page. So in the properties, just below the properties, you see the master page. Click on that and you can choose from these master pages which are appearing the type that you like. You can scroll up and down and you will see different types of master pages. Click on the one which you like to apply on this particular image. Right click on it. You will see a small box appears which shows you options. The options will be, do you want to apply this to only this slide, or do you want to apply this to all the selected slides, to all the slides, and show large preview. So since we want to apply it only to this slide, we say apply only to selected slide. And you will see the master page gets applied to this fourth slide. Let's work on the fifth slide. We click on the fifth slide, get this slide again. Now we have to go back to the properties in the slide layout. Instead of master pages, we click on the properties. The first option here, as you can see in the video, and then select the blank slide. So once again we have the blank slide here. Let's use this slide and let's use FontWorks option. So click on the FontWorks option in the drawing toolbar and select the FontWork of your choice, the one which you like. Once you select the FontWork of your choice, that particular FontWork gets applied on your slide. You will see, you can click on OK after selecting, and you will see FontWork written in that style that you have chosen on your slide. Now if you double click on this, you will see a cursor appearing and the word FontWork is written there. You can use the backspace key to delete the word FontWork and type any name or any word of your choice. For instance, we are typing Computer Shiksha. After typing, click on the side in your slide as is being shown in the video here, and you will see that the word Computer Shiksha appears in the style that you had chosen. Again, if you select this, these blue dots or green dots are available and you can use them to resize the image. So you can make it bigger or smaller depending on your liking. So this is how, what we have learned now is how to insert new slides and how to work, do different kinds of work on each of these slides. Do you all remember what is the standard toolbar about which you have learned earlier also? Standard toolbar is a shortcut method using which you can customize the Impress standard toolbar as per your requirements. Within the standard toolbar, you can keep those options of the menu bar which you need to use repeatedly, like New, Open, Save, Copy Paste, Undo Redo, etc. Next, you will all learn about all the options of the standard toolbar. The very first option is for New. Using the New option, you can get a new document of Impress. Can you tell in how many ways we can bring up a new Impress document? You can bring up a new Impress document in three ways. In the first method, you can use the File option of the menu bar. In the second method, you can use the shortcut command. And in the third method, you can use the standard toolbar. Do you know which shortcut command you will need to use to bring up a new document for Impress? To get a new Impress document, you will use the Ctrl plus N command. So, using the methods explained above, you can get a new Impress document in three ways. Let us learn by watching this video about using the standard toolbar. Watch this video to learn various methods to open a new Impress file. In the first method, you need to just click on the file option of the menu bar and then click on new, and from that option select presentation. You will see a slide opening. Click on create and your new file is available. Let us close this because we want to learn the next method. After you close this, you will see in the standard toolbar there is an option for new, so you can click there. Click on this and again the presentation wizard opens and you can click on create option as is being shown in the video, and you will have a new Impress file. Let's close this so that we can learn the third method. The third method is a shortcut method where you can just press the Ctrl key with your left hand and press the N key, Ctrl plus N. As soon as you press Ctrl plus N, you will get a new Impress file that you can work upon. So these are three methods to open a new Impress file. In order to open the Impress file, what shortcut command will you use? In order to open the Impress document using the shortcut method, we will use the Ctrl plus O command. Can you all open the Impress document using the standard toolbar? Let us learn by watching this video about using the standard toolbar to open the Impress file. Watch this video now to learn how we can open an already saved file. For this, let's first close the file that is already opened on our Impress page. So we just close this and then we use the Windows plus R command to open the run box and type SImpress. Click on OK and you are now opening the Impress file. This box will appear as is being shown in the video, the presentation wizard. Click on create and your new Impress file gets opened. Now we have to open the already saved file. So for that, take your cursor to the open icon in the standard toolbar and click on that. So we take our cursor, click on the open icon, a box opens which shows you, you should know the location where your file is. So we can look through the locations, desktops, documents, videos, wherever our file is. Since our file is in the desktop, we select desktop. Then we can scroll up and down within this box, the desktop, and look for our file. Or we can type the file name at the bottom if we know the exact file name, and you can find your file. Select the file and then click on open, and you will see that the file you had saved as Impress class 1 gets opened on your Impress page. So this is how you will use the shortcut icon command from the standard toolbar to open your Impress file. Next option is for document as email. By using this option, you can email your current Impress file to anyone you want to. However, you must have an Outlook account to be able to use this option. Let us watch this video and learn how document as email is used. Watch this video to learn how we can send an impress file using the document as email icon in the standard toolbar. To send this as a document with email, you need to have an Outlook account on the system that you are working on. Take your cursor to the standard toolbar, to the icon which is for document as email. Click on that, left click, and you will see an email page opens for Outlook, and you can see that your document is already shown as an attachment for this email. Here you need to type the address or the email ID to whom you want to send this document. For instance, here, just as an example, we are typing acd@gmail.com, and then we will click on the send button. You can also type a subject and you can also type some text if you desire. Click on send and this document will be sent attached as an email. Since we do not want to send it right now, we will just close this and say no to this small box saying do you want to save the changes, since we don't want to send it right now. So this is how you will use the document as email option to send your document. Next option is for export directly as PDF. By using this option, you can directly convert your current impress file into PDF format. Do you all remember why we make a PDF file? In a PDF file, no user can make any changes. This means that after we have entered the desired text and inserted any objects in our document and then saved our file as PDF file, then no one can make any changes in that file. Normally, you can open the PDF file using the Adobe Reader software, but in Windows 8 and 10, you can open it even without the Adobe Reader. Let us learn by watching this video about converting our impress file into PDF format. Watch this video to learn how we can convert our impress file into PDF format. So to do that, you have to take your cursor or the pointer to the convert to PDF icon in the standard toolbar. Click on the icon which says export directly as PDF. A box opens which is asking you to define where you want to save this file as PDF. So you can pick the location. If you want to save it on desktop or videos or documents, since we want to save it in desktop, we click on desktop and then we type the file name as impress class 1 PDF and then click on save option, and this file directly gets saved as a PDF file. To see where this file has been saved, you can minimize this current impress file by clicking here, and you can see that this file has been saved in PDF format on your desktop. So this is how you can save. If you double click on it, the PDF file will open and you can see all your slides in this PDF file also. You can close this. This is how you can save your file, impress file, directly as PDF format. With the help of the standard toolbar, you can also directly print your impress file if there is a printer connected to your computer. For doing this, you will use the option for print file directly. Let us now watch the video and understand how we can use the standard toolbar to print directly. This video shows us how we can use the icon in the standard toolbar for directly printing our file. So take the cursor or the pointer to the icon which has a printer which says print directly and click there, print file directly. If you click here, the file gets printed. Since we don't want to print right now, you also need not click on this or select this option. But this is the option that you will use to print your file directly on the printer if you have a printer attached. With the help of the standard toolbar, you can also use the options for copy, cut and paste. Can you use the options for copy, cut and paste? Let us learn with the help of this video how you can use the options for copy, cut and paste. Let us now learn with the help of this video to use the icons for copy, cut and paste from the standard toolbar. So, to use copy and paste, we first select an image in our Impress file. We have selected the slide 3. We want to copy this. So we first select this image and you can see that the icons in the standard toolbar are now available. So you can click on the copy icon or you can use the shortcut command Ctrl plus C to copy this image. Now if you go to the second slide and you want to paste this image of the diamond on top of this earlier image, you just go to the paste option, click there, or you can use the shortcut command Ctrl plus V to paste it. While the image is selected, you can move it to a place where you want to place this image. Now let us also, for using the cut and paste option, let's get a new slide. So to do that, we are going to the slide pane, right clicking on it and then selecting new slide. So we have a new slide, which is the sixth slide. We go back to the second slide, select the image of the diamond. After selecting, you have to click on it. Then you can use the cut icon and click on it, or you can use the shortcut command Ctrl plus X. Next, go back to the new slide that you have taken, which is the sixth slide. And here you can go and click on the paste icon or use Ctrl plus V to get the image of the diamond on this new slide. You can move this image and place it where you like to place it. So this is how you can use the icons for copy, cut and paste from the standard toolbar in your Impress file. Why do we use the format paintbrush? With the help of the option for format paintbrush, you can get the same formatting that you may have done on any one of your slides or an object or shape on any of your other slides. Let us watch this video and learn how we can use the format paintbrush. Watch this video now to see how we can use the format paintbrush icon of the standard toolbar. In this slide, we have an image which already has been formatted with a gradient color. Now let's select from the toolbar, from the drawing bar, an option so that we can get another shape on the same slide. So we have selected a smiley face and we drag this here to make a smiley face on this slide itself. Now we want to copy the same format of the diamond on the smiley face. So we select the diamond first, the diamond image, then click on the format paintbrush icon in the standard toolbar and bring the pointer to the smiley face and click on it. You will notice as soon as we click here, the same format which was on the diamond gets applied to the smiley face also. So this is how you can use the format print brush. Let us take another example. Let us do this in a different slide. So let's go to the second slide where we have the cylindrical object which has already been formatted with this greenish color. Again, let's from the drawing toolbar, let's select an image. Let's select a circle and drag a circle, a small circle here. Now, since we want to copy the format of the cylinder onto the circle, we first select the image of the cylinder. So we click on the cylinder image to select it. Take our pointer to the format paintbrush icon in the standard toolbar, click there, and then bring the pointer to the circle and click on it. As soon as we click, you can see the format gets copied onto the image of the circle also. This is how you will use the format paintbrush. Just like you all use the options for copy, cut and paste, you will now also use the options for undo and redo. Can you use the options for undo and redo? Watch the video and learn how you can use the options for undo and redo. Watch this video and learn how we can use the undo and redo icons in the standard toolbar. Remember this in this slide which is being shown, in the end we had inserted a circle and then used the same format with the paintbrush, format paintbrush. If we click on undo, first the format goes away. If we click on undo once again, the circle which we had inserted will also go away, as you can see in the video. Next, if we go to another slide where we had a diamond and a smiley, we had inserted the smiley and formatted it. So if we click on undo, that formatting of the smiley goes away. You can see in the sixth slide, if we click on undo once again, the smiley face will also go away. If we go back to the sixth slide and click on redo, first the smiley will come back. You can see in the sixth slide in the slide pane, as is being shown in the video to you, the smiley has come back. And if we do a redo once again, the formatting of the smiley will also come back. Similarly, if we click on redo once again, in the second slide, the circle's format we had removed, that comes back. First the circle comes back, then the formatting also comes back. So this is how you will use undo and redo. Let us use it in the first slide also, where there is some text. We select one line here and delete it. If we have deleted it by mistake, you can now make use of the undo command. You can click on undo and you will see that that line comes back. However, if you didn't want the line and you actually wanted to remove it, you can now click on redo so that the line will again get deleted. So this is how you can use undo and redo command on your Impress file from the standard toolbar icons itself. Similarly, while you are working on Impress, you can make use of options for chart, hyperlink and tables in your Impress slides. You can use the chart option to show your Excel or spreadsheet data in the form of a presentation to anyone. You will learn more about this in the module on spreadsheets. What will you need to do to create a link on your Impress slide to another document? In order to provide a link for any document on your Impress slide, you will need to use the hyperlink option. Let us watch the video and learn more about how the hyperlink option is used. Watch this video to learn how we can use the hyperlink icon in the standard toolbar to provide a link in our Impress file to another file through hyperlink. So to do that, let's first select a slide on which we want to apply the hyperlink. Keep the cursor where you want to apply the hyperlink. So we have selected the first slide and place the cursor as is being shown in the video. Then take your pointer to the icon for hyperlink in the standard toolbar. Click there and a box opens in which you can see a yellow icon for open file. Click on that and a box opens which shows you the address or the locations where your file is. You should know where your file is existing. For instance, if it is on desktop, you will select the desktop from the address bar and then scroll up or down to look for your file. Once you find your file, select that by clicking on it and then click on open. Once you click on the open option, you can see that in this box for the hyperlink, the link address is provided. There is a box for text. So if you want this hyperlink to appear in a word or you want to give it a name, you can type that and the hyperlink will appear with this name on your Impress file. Like we have shown Impress PDF. Click on apply and then click on close and you will see that on our Impress file, the Impress PDF has been inserted. The hyperlink has been inserted. If you want to open it, take your cursor here, press the control key and then press the left button and you will see in the taskbar, you can see that the PDF file has been opened. You can look for that file by clicking on the PDF icon in the taskbar as is being shown in the video. And you can see that the PDF file has been opened and you can see or use that PDF file. So this is how you will use the hyperlink icon in the standard toolbar to insert a hyperlink in your Impress file. You can close it since you don't want to use it right now and carry on with your Impress file. Now, all of you go ahead and show how you will use the standard toolbar to create a table on a new slide. Will you be able to create such a table? In case you face any problems in doing this, you can watch this video and learn how a table can be created in your Impress slide. Let us now watch this video and see how we can insert a table on our Impress slide file using the icon in the standard toolbar. For this, we first need to create a new slide. So go to the slide pane, right click on it and then click on the new slide option. And you can see, as is being shown in the video, a new slide has been created. Now, take your pointer to the table icon in the standard toolbar and click on that. A box opens, which is for inserting tables, and it allows you to specify the number of columns and the number of rows you want. You can increase or decrease. Click on OK, and you can see a table gets inserted. On the right side of the slide, where the properties are listed, there down below you can see table design. So you can select one of the table designs that you like and by clicking on that particular design, you can select the table design that you like for your table. Once you click on that, it gets inserted on your slide. That design gets applied. So once you click on this, on the outside of the table on the slide, your slide is ready, the table is ready, and you can work on it. The next option is for display grid. Do you know what is display grid? Using the display grid, you can apply a design on your impress slide. When you select the display grid option, some dots will appear on your slide. Let us watch this video and see how we use the display grid option. This video shows us that we can use the display grid icon in the standard toolbar to display the grid lines on our impress file. First, select the slide on which you want to display the grid lines. Take your pointer to the display grid icon in the standard toolbar and click on it. And you can see now light colored lines will appear all over this particular slide. If you press F5 and see it in a different view, these lines will not be visible as is being shown in the video to you. So these lines are visible to you in the normal view only. If you want to remove the grid lines, you have to take the pointer again to the display grid icon and once again select that. So this way you can use the display grid icon to show or hide the display grid lines. Can you all hide and unhide or show the options for the standard toolbar? In order to hide or unhide the option for the standard toolbar, you need to click on the control button or the drop-down option of this toolbar. This control button or drop-down option is highlighted and shown to you in the picture in front of you. Watch the video to know more about hiding and unhiding the option for the standard toolbar. By watching this video, we are now going to learn how we can hide or unhide the options of the standard toolbar. To hide or unhide the options from the standard toolbar, you need to click on the drop-down button which appears on the right side of the standard toolbar and click on Customize Toolbar. As you can see in the video, a box opens, and in this, in the Events, in the Toolbars option, you can see the options are available to you. Whatever has been selected here is being shown in the standard toolbar. So if you want to hide the options, you have to unselect them. Like we have just unselected the New option, we have unselected Open option, Save option, and you can scroll up or down. Document as email also we have unselected. So all these options will not be now visible in the standard toolbar. We have also unselected export as PDF. Then we can just go and click on the OK button, and this change will get applied, and you can see in the standard toolbar all those options which you had unselected are no longer available to you. Those icons are not visible now, or they have become hidden. If you want to bring back some of these options again, you will again go to the drop-down button on the right side of the standard toolbar, click on Customize Toolbar, and then make sure that you are in the Toolbars option. Now we are selecting New, we have selected Open, we have selected Save, we have selected Document as Email, and then Export directly as PDF also. This change is taking place in the standard toolbar, which you can see in the back. And if you click on OK, you can see that all these options are now shown once again in the standard toolbar. So you have New, you have Open, you have Document as Email, you have Export directly as PDF. All the options are available now. So this is how you can hide or unhide the various options from the standard toolbar. The next option is for the line and filling toolbar. So let us now learn about the line and filling toolbar. Watch this video to learn how we can hide and show the options for the line and filling toolbar. In this video, we are going to see how we can hide and show the options of the line and filling toolbar. So to do that, you have to click on the drop-down button on the right side of the line and filling toolbar and select the customize toolbar option. By default, you see that it comes to toolbars with the line and filling toolbar. Now, there are various options shown here. Those which are tick marked are being shown in the line and filling toolbar. If you unselect these options, like we have unselected line, arrow style, line style, all these options will not be shown in the line and filling toolbar, the ones which we are unselecting. So we have also unselected line color. We can scroll up and down, and we have unselected the area also. And then click on OK button. Area style filling also we have unselected. And as soon as you click on the OK button, all these changes will get applied. And you can see in the line and filling toolbar now available to you, all those options which we had unselected are not visible or have got hidden. If you want to change again or show some of the options again, you have to once again click on the drop-down button on the right side of the line and filling toolbar, as is being shown in the video. Click on the customize toolbar option. From the box that opens, you are already by default in the line and filling toolbar. Now select the options that you want to show again, like we have selected line, we have selected arrow style, we have selected line color, and so on. All the options that you want to show in your line and filling toolbar, you can keep selecting them. If you notice, you can see that these changes are already being shown in the line and filling toolbar. However, to apply them, you have to click on OK, and you can see that your line and filling toolbar now shows all the options which you had just recently selected. This is how you will use the show and hide options for the line and filling toolbar. Now, all of you close your Impress file and properly shut down your systems. Today's class ends here. In today's class, you all learned about the various options of the standard toolbar. You all first learned about what is the standard toolbar. Then you learned about how the options of the standard toolbar are used, like new, open, save, copy paste, display grid, slide, slide layout, and slide design, etc. Then you also learned about the line and filling toolbar. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Thank you.